ended, where we all have dedicated our lives to improving the lives of women and girls. Maybe in different ways, but I hope now we see that we have more in common than we have differences. I also want to thank the brave men that are here, the historians that are here, and students that are here. We really appreciate your support. I'm very proud to be in such company, to just be one of you. It's a thrill to be here, I must tell you that. But the people here took part in integrating the want ads, in securing safe and legal abortions, creating safe spaces for abused women.
Barbara, and love everybody. It's so great to see you.
Expect fresh tomorrow.
There wasn't one in the entire country. There's a plan for one in Washington. It's only online now. It's been in the planning for years and years, and we don't know when it will be up and running. It's unimaginable that 51% of the population did not have one space dedicated to its history. I'm talking general history now, I'm not talking the arts or some of the specialized areas. And so we looked and looked, we had lots of libraries, lots of university libraries who wanted to house our artifacts and our papers. But all that would mean is that they would put those things away for scholars to request that they be taken out for study. We wanted something that could be made into an exhibit that little Girl Scouts would come and look at, and fourth graders would come, and parents would bring their children to. There was no museum. Now we have one. The New York Historical Society, which those of you who are local know, is on Central Park West, right next door to the American Museum of Natural History, has opened last month a center for women's history.
That we're talking about it, that we're